Hello students, good morning. We have already started a topic differentiation. From this topic we have done the basic rules for differentiation, product rule and quotient rule, then implicit function, logarithmic differentiation, parametric function, chain rule, derivative of a function with respect to other functions. In our previous lecture we have also done one theorem based on this topic. Now in our today lecture we will continue with that theorem. We will do the second theorem, that is the Lagrange's mean value theorem. There are also some conditions, theorem is applicable or not applicable. As per the Rolle's theorem, there were also three conditions. In Lagrange's mean value theorem, two conditions are there, then we apply the third condition. According to that, first condition is, if function is for closed interval a and b approaches to real number, then function continues on closed interval a and b. Function is differentiable on open interval a and b. Then there must exist a real number c. Any number c belongs to open interval a and b, such that we will apply this formula. In that case, Rolle's theorem f dash c is equal to 0, but in Lagrange's mean value theorem, we will apply that f dash c is equal to fb minus fa divided by b minus a. Now, I am taking one example. Lagrange's mean value theorem is applicable or not applicable? From this, mean value theorem is applicable for fx is equal to under root of 5 minus x and interval is given to you minus 3, 6. It means you have to put the value between minus 3 and 6. When you put the value between minus 3 and 6, one value 6 will be there. When you put that value 6, you will get a negative result. And negative of any root number is imaginary number. So, it is not a continue. Then write it. First of all, we will write the statement as it is. Fx is equal to under root of 5 minus x on closed interval minus 3, 6. Fx is not defined if x is greater than 5. As we have already discussed now, if we take the value greater than 5, we will get a negative root number, which is imaginary number, not a real number. And condition is for only the real number. Clear? Therefore, fx is not continue for minus 3 and 6, close interval. Fx is not differentiable for minus 3 and 6, open interval. Since conditions of Lagrange's mean value theorem are not satisfied, so, theorem is not applicable for fx is equal to under root of 5 minus x on closed interval minus 6, minus 3, 6. Now, I am taking one more example in which you have to find out that value there also. Verify Lagrange's mean value theorem for fx is equal to, now statement is given to you, x is into 1 minus log x and interval is given to you 1 and 2. Given fx is equal to a statement given to you. Fx is defined for all x because whenever you 1 and 2 and between 1 and 2 any value you put here you will definitely get the answer. So that you will write here fx is defined for all x belongs to closed interval 1 and 2. Since log function, because every log function is having some value. Whether it is infinity also there, because log 0 is infinity. Log function is continue and differentiable. Where it is continue and differentiable? For its given domain. Whatever value is given to you, it should be continue and differentiable for that. It is a domain of the log. Therefore, fx is continue on the closed interval. Fx is differentiable on the open interval. Now you will find out the differentiation of fx there. Whenever you find out the differentiation of this value, here two functions are there. One function and the second function. You will apply the product rule. First function ddx of second function plus second function ddx of first function. Now 1 minus log x differentiation is minus 1 by x. Now x differentiation is 1 there. Now x and x cancel, minus 1 and plus 1 again cancel, you will get the value minus log x. It is the value of f dash x. Clear? Now, condition of Lagrange's mean value theorems are satisfied. There must exist at least one value of c which belongs to open interval 1 and 2. Then you will apply a formula f dash c is equal to fb minus fa upon b minus a. What is the value of b here? B value is 2. What is the value of a here? A value is 1. Therefore, you will find out the value f2. F2, when you put the value 2 there, you will get 2 into 1 minus log 2. When you put the value 1 there, 1 minus log 1. So log 1 is 0. So value is 1 here. Now, minus log x. You have to find out f dash c there now. So f dash c is minus log c. Minus log c is equal to 2 into 1 minus log 2 minus 1 upon 2 minus 1. By applying the arrow method, you will get the value minus log c is equal to 2 minus 2 log 2 minus 1 upon 1, because log term is there. So we will apply all log conditions also there. Shift value there, it will get the positive sign. Now 2 log 2 minus log c is equal to 1, 2 log 2. Exponent rule we have done now. Then it will become log 2 raised to power 2 minus log c. It will become log 4 minus log c. Now you will apply the quotient rule here. Log m minus log m upon n, 4 upon c is equal to log e. Log e, 1 is the value of log e, because log and log both are the same term, drop out. As sign and sign drop, same log and log is also drop. You will get the value 4 upon c is equal to e. It means you have to find out the value of c here. You will shift the value. You get that c is equal to 4 upon e, which belongs to the value 1 and 2. Because when whatever the value is e there, when you divided that value 4 to that value, you will get definitely answer in between these. Hence, at last you will write on the same way. Hence, Lagrange's mean value theorem is verified for fx is equal to x into f1 minus log x on 1 and 2 for the closed interval. Now, the second type, which is also very important, theorem is already held there. And you have to find out the two unknown variables. Two unknown variables, you will apply their elimination method. Now, from that statement, fx is equal to x cube plus ax square plus bx. Now, a and b, two unknown variables are there, and x is belongs to 1 and 2. At point, x is equal to 4 by 3. X is equal to 4 by 3 means this is the value of c here. Because this value, you have to get that after applying the Rolle's theorem. Find a and b. Now, same way, first of all, we will write out the given condition. Fx is equal to given value as it is. Then f dash x, what is the value of f dash x? X cube 3x square. Ax square is 2ax, bx is b there. Because Rolle's theorem is already held here. Therefore, whatever value x is there, that is the value of c. C is equal to 4 by 3, which belongs to the open interval 1 and 2. Now, what are the two basic conditions for Rolle's theorem? Fa is equal to fb. So, what is the value of fa here? F1. F1 is equal to f2. And the second condition is there. F dash c is equal to 0. From these two conditions, you will get the two equations. Then you will get the value of a and b. Now, when you have put the value 1 there, in f1, you will get a 1 equation by substituting 1 here. 1 plus a plus b. When you put the value 2 here, you will again get 1 equation. This equation is there. Clear? By shifting the value, you will get 1 equation. After that, you will get the value f dash c is equal to 0. F dash c is equal to 3c square plus 2ac plus b. 3c square plus 2ac plus b. What is the value of c? 4 upon 3. You put the value of 4 upon 3 here. Plus 2a into 4 upon 3. When you solve this value, you will get an equation 16 plus 8a plus 3b is equal to 0. Now you are having two equations. One equation and the other equation. And you have to find out the value of a and b. How will you find out? By applying the elimination method. Now I am showing the result here. By applying elimination method, we multiply this term by 3 because I am equalizing the term of b here. Clear bache? Now 3b is there. 9a plus 3b is equal to minus 21. 8a plus 3b is equal to minus 16. When you subtract the value, you will get value a is equal to minus 5, b is equal to 8. Now students, you will get one link related to this topic. Go through that link. Your exercise sums are also there. Do more and more practice related to this topic, because one 6 marks question is confirmed from this topic. Clear? I hope you will do more practice there. Thank you.